Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to be learning about Python data types part 2. So let's get on with the video. So let's start Python data types part 2. Creating arrays with a defined data. We use the array function to create arrays. This function can take an optional argument. Dtype that allows us to define the expected data type of the array elements. And what if a value cannot be converted? If type is in which elements can't be cached, then num will raise an value error. The value error in Python, value error is raised when the type is passed to argument is to a function is unexpected or incorrect. Converting data type on existing array. The best way to change the data type that is in an existing array is to basically making copy of the array and use asType method. The asType function creates a copy of the array, allows you to specify the data type as a parameter. The data type can be for string like f or for float I. Or you can use the data type directly like float for float and int for integer. Now let's go to the code. For that we need to go to Jupyter Notebook. Let's open it. And we have to write some code. Now let's write the code. So first what we have to do is always in these codes is import numb. Import numb as np arr is equal to np dot array. So what we are going to do is we are going to create an array with the data type string. So now we are going to put square brackets and one. Now we are going to put the data type as string . Now we're going to put capital S and then put a normal bracket . Now what we need to do is we just put it here . Now we'll print R and print R's data types. And if we run the code, wait. We have syntax error here. Now if you run it, it's B1, B3, so the error was because we had put here two brackets, that's why it was an error. Next code is, this Now this we are going to be like value error, that this is going to raise an error, this code. A, then comma 2 comma 3. Now what we need to do is put to not put comma there, then we have to put space d type equals to I. Now this, yes, now this is supposed to raise, yes, invalid literal for int with base 10 a, so it was supposed to raise an error because it's invalid literal for int. It can't be have a base with a. Next is like this code, but we're gonna have two variables, so first we're gonna import numb as np, and then we're gonna put in this variable np.array. Now we're going to type here another variable that is new array, which is equal to arr dot as type shift i. Now we're gonna go print now. Let's run it. We got both. We are putting the, this is in float, and this we have made it into int. That is it for this video. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe.